All right, so we're at the side of the road. Our fucking tire popped.
Yeah, I know. I should have a jack. It's not the point.
Point is, we just got back from Tennessee. We went to go check out this TikTok cult people were talking about online. If you don't know anything about it, then here it is.
So my girlfriend found this place. TikTok.
Talking TikTok commune.
The TikTok commune.
Commune on an open plot of land.
TikTok? The garden.
The garden.
Cult?
This is a cult.
Say it's not a cult, but it's gotta be. It's gotta be, man.
What's up? Tell me a little bit more about this place. Like, how'd you come across it, and why you're interested in it and stuff?
All right. So my girlfriend found this place on TikTok. I don't know how she found it. I don't know what hole of TikTok she was in, but literally, it's a cult. It's gotta be a cult. They say it's not a cult. But it's gotta be. It's gotta be, man. Half of me believes that you're gonna go there if you go and not even not come back. I don't
think I'm gonna go back. You think I'll go there and get stuck there?
I think so. It's called like the tree, life tree.
Yeah, man. I'm gonna head out tomorrow.
I said you're not coming back. Are you and your girl gonna stay? You guys both going?
Yeah, we're going. We're gonna stay in the van. We got the van like fully livable. We got a portable battery. We got like one of those 5-gallon bottles and a water pump. So,
no shit.
Yeah.
Well, look at that. You have an asset for the commune.
Oh, I'm gonna come bearing gifts. I'm gonna bring a painting.
What if you get there and they're not even there?
So
what if you get there and it's just all staged?
That would suck.
All right,
peace out.
Good luck with the travels next year when you leave.
All right, I will. Love you, buddy. Peace.
Love you, too. Bye.
And the next day, we left. So we have about 30 more minutes in this ride, but for the past like 20 minutes we've had no service at all. We're literally like in the middle of fucking nowhere. Hopefully we don't have any trouble finding the place because we literally don't have cell service. Like, we can't even use our maps and shit. How do you feel about it? What are your thoughts?
What are my thoughts on having no cell service? I sure hope that we can get back home safely without our maps until we have service. I hope that maybe there's service like in like when we get a little bit closer, you know?
I don't know. He posts TikToks, so he has to have some sort of service, like,
yeah.
Somehow.
Yeah. But I'm also kind of afraid because I don't know anybody in Tennessee.
Me either.
I don't know if it's like what like these people are like. I mean, we got rednecks in North Carolina. I don't know what Tennessee's like.
Probably more rednecky, who knows?
Yeah, and there's nobody out here, too. So, I don't know.
I think we'll be fine. That's what we're hoping for. We're gonna go there and people are gonna be cool. Fingers crossed.
The garden.
Wow.
Someone just beep at us?
Yeah.
Welcome home. Violence free, drug free. What does it say? It looks like there are houses over there.
Where should I park? In front of this RV?
I'm not sure, baby.
I have to pee so fucking bad.
There's a chicken in the tree. What the fuck? Someone screamed, hey!
All right, so we just got here. We don't see anyone yet. So we're looking around.
The only thing I see, oh, there's people up there.
There's people?
Yeah, up there.
Hello. How's it going?
Hello.
Hey, how's it going?
Chicken in the tree.
Hi, hi, hi.
Hello.
What's your name?
I'm Samaj.
Samaj?
Samaj, yes.
Cheyenne, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Hi, what's your name?
Brianna.
Brianna, Cheyenne, nice to meet you guys. Welcome, welcome to the garden. Welcome
home.
Thank you. Yeah, absolutely. So, they just blew the dinner horn, so you guys just made it just in time.
Oh, wow. Nice.
Fresh food ready down in the outside kitchen. Would you guys like a tour first? You want to go straight there and meet everyone? Probably
do a little tour.
Yeah. A little tour on the way.
We brought gifts. We brought a painting.
Yay! Awesome. Yeah, I'd present it down there if you want to.
Cool,
yeah, that's perfect.
We'll
so this right
you.
Here.
And what's your name again? I'm sorry.
Cheyenne.
Cheyenne?
Yes.
Cheyenne.
Yes.
Cheyenne. Okay.
Shy for short.
Okay.
However, yeah, exactly.
Cool.
So this is our solar office that we have. We work off of a signal booster, so that's where if you need to have any kind of Wi-Fi or service, you need to make phone call or any of that kind of stuff, that's where you would do it.
Cool.
Then we've got here, which is the generator for the well, where the water pump will go, and then it goes to the outside kitchen where we clean dishes and get water from the well as well.
Okay, cool.
A few of these are living spaces, buses, storage spaces as well. This is the free bus. Tons of stuff that people just kind of leave, and you can come in and take what you like and wear what you like.
Wow.
All of that jazz.
They have guitars.
I'm gonna actually grab a little hoodie while I'm in here.
That's awesome.
Yeah, that's super dope.
Wow. It's super, super cool. It's neat because it's just give and take, like I said. I mean, there's kids' stuff in here. There's jackets if you ever need, like, a coat when it gets cold and all that stuff. So super fun.
Wow, that is really cool.
You don't mind if I record you, do you?
Oh, not at all. Okay. There are a few people that do. But they'll let you know.
Okay. Yeah.
But I don't mind.
Where do you get your wood?
A few different places, like the sawmill. We'll get wood from there. A lot of, like, the neighbors will give us wood as well.
Cool.
This is one of our compost houses. So, you know, peeing is just outside anywhere that's of your comfortability. And then pooping, obviously, is there where we have compost and sawdust that we put over the compost, and then within a couple of years it gets made into perfectly good soil.
So cool.
Yeah. Oops. And here's the well.
Careful.
We've got a little loft up there that we all kind of hang out and do, like, on, like, bonfire nights or just, like, cold nights. We'll go up there and hang.
People?
Yes, yes. This is Turtle.
Hey.
Nice to meet you.
How's it going?
How are you?
I'm Samaj.
I'm Brianna.
Nice to meet you.
You too.
Is that a video?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh. Sorry.
How long have you been here?
I've been here a little... Oh, so Mitch approaching, he doesn't like to be on video either, just to let you know.
Okay.
So that's another little cabin, and then that is the shower house as well.
Can we see it? Can we
check
it out?
Absolutely. There's a little pump that runs down here with that water when we start a fire up there, and then you turn it on, and you just shower as necessary, so.
Nice.
Yeah.
What's that say? Be the change you wish to see. I have that tattooed on me.
Yeah! That's actually like so many places around here. You'll find just like random cute little messages like that, especially in the outside kitchen where we just opened that up about a week, actually a week ago today. Mm. So yeah, ping-pong, pool table. We're working on the chimney right now. They're working on kind of building stuff up there and downstairs as well.
Oh wow, this is...
But mm-hmm. Yeah, this is one of the newer projects that's going on around here.
Wow.
So it's super fun.
And everyone just builds this to themselves?
Yeah, we all, so we have council two different times a week on Sundays and Wednesdays, and that's where we all come to consensus. So we do like a 10-second silence, and if anybody, you know, disagrees or anything like that, then you speak up within that 10 seconds, and that's how decisions get made around here. So then we just talk about projects and lots of different stuff during council. So when that happens, yeah, this is just one of the new projects where they say, hey, if we need a little help here, we need a little help here today, that's when we talk about it. So,
cool.
Yeah, yeah. But it's, I mean, just walking around, you know, see, like, you can, it's really fun. You don't have to necessarily be designated to any project. You can pop in and help here and pop in and help here in the garden and pop in and help here. So it's just kind of,
nice.
It's nice, yeah. So another compost toilet right there. And then a few more of the cabins. We're in X amount of places for that. So I would probably maybe turn the camera off here and then maybe...
So what are your thoughts so far?
I think it's pretty cool. I mean, it's pretty dope how everyone, like, you know, does everything together. Like, she literally said that they all, like, just got the telephone pole and, like, put it up to, like, get cell service out here, which is kind of dope. They're building that whole new room, which they're doing themselves, which is cool. Give me your bowl, please. Do you want, baby?
Okay, so we got here a couple hours before it got dark. We got a tour of the place. It's pretty cool. It's like off grid, but it's not like super off grid. Like, there's definitely like civilization around. You're not seeing like Walmarts and shit, but there's definitely like some houses and things that you're passing. The last 40 minutes of the ride here, we had no service, which kind of freaked us out because we were just going through some mountains. But once we got far enough, once we got closer in, we, you know, we got service again, so that wasn't bad. Really windy roads, no streetlights. I would not like suggest doing the drive at night. But yeah, so far it's pretty cool. They have outhouses for bathrooms, so that's gonna be interesting. We got some food.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you'll probably see that in here.
Yeah, no, I'm editing in there. What did you think of the food?
I thought it was good. It was rice and like some vegetables in this soup thing. They have the garden was really cool, actually. Mm-hmm. They had like an herb swirl.
Yeah.
An herb swirl.
Yep.
And it was literally like a swirl of herbs that they had planting and, you know, a whole bunch of different They had peach trees, which my mom also has peach trees in the backyard, and they had strawberries.
I don't think it's a cult. It's like, I could definitely see why people would think that, though. People aren't really living here. Most of the people here are just travelers, so a lot of the other people here have also been here under the 10 days. It doesn't seem like anyone's been here, like, permanently. Even the people that have been here before have came, and then they left, and they came back, and things like that. We met one couple that said that they conceived their kid here.
Yeah. Uh-huh. He was born here, or if they took him to a hospital or something. I don't really know. Because I don't know when was the last time he left.
It's kind of cool. There's a little nursery area for them. Yeah. There's a good, like, I feel like a lot of different age groups of people. There's some people that seem pretty young around our age, and there's people who seem a little older, but everyone's pretty nice so far. We didn't want to have the camera too much just because, like, you know, we just got here, so we wanted to walk around and see what's going on.
Good.
Yeah.
Okay.
What would you how would you describe the place to people?
So the garden is an off-grid, egalitarian, intentional community, very focused on sustainable living and spreading that message to as many people as possible. That's why we have an open door policy. Once people come here, the space is ever evolving. It's based on whoever's here at the time. Whoever's here at the time is considered an equal and is just as, you know, strong of a voice as people that have been here for 5 years or whatever. Every decision is based on 100% consensus. So even if someone who's been here for 3 days doesn't want something to happen, that thing won't happen because we need 100% consensus to do anything. So we'll sit in council for a long time sometimes just because we want to make sure that we're all agreeing on what's going down in the space. So we try to be as non-hierarchical as possible while still keeping a productive pace and, you know, growing food as organically as possible, building structures so that more people can experience that. Yeah, and then just giving away the food for free just to, you know, show people that organic food can be available if you put the work in.
So everything in the kitchen, is that like you guys make it here and things?
You know, winter vegetables, locally grown, you know, like we have all the leafy greens and stuff like that. In the winter, yeah, it's a little bit more scarce with food. Sometimes there's like hunted meat that's donated from like the locals. We have a good relationship with the town, so like some locals want to hunt and they don't want to process it. So like when I first got here, there was like 2 deers that was donated. Mm. So we like tried to use as much of the deer as possible, things like that. I have never been here in the summer, but I know that they've said that there's been more food than they can even consume.
Yeah, that's awesome.
So we just have a like table in the town and give away food and things like that.
I think it's awesome that like it's like a good place for travelers. I feel like, you know, everyone maybe thinks that like a bunch of people are like just living here like for years and years and like, you know, a lot of things, but I think it's cool that it's like people coming and going and things like that. Can you explain the 10-day?
Yeah, so a lot of intentional communities that I've been to have been more like, you know, 10 people living off-grid and they're more closed. You have to like send an email and request if you want to come and things like that. The open door policy here is set in place so that people that have never experienced this lifestyle before can have like the ease of just coming in and coming in for a few days and experiencing it, because the mission of this place is to show people, as many people as possible, about off-grid living. But with that, of course, you know, we need to also have some kind of system set in place to, you know, kind of weed out people that aren't really interested in the mission, maybe just want a place to stay, or, you know, somebody who's maybe violent or somebody that people don't necessarily, you know, vibe with. So that's the 10-day rule is people, anybody is welcome to stay for 10 days. If somebody comes that's, you know, doesn't make people feel safe, then we also have a system set in place where anybody that's been here for 2 weeks can ask that person to leave at any time, as long as they let everyone in the community know that they're doing so. So if you somebody comes in and they're drunk and they're like, fuck these hippies, we can like run around quick and say like, hey, I'm gonna ask this guy to leave, actually, he's not, you know, and that can happen.
Yeah.
Apart from that, it's after 10 days of being here, you can request to stay for longer. So you can say like, oh, I actually want to stay another month. I want to stay till the end of the summer. And then 100% of the community that's here at that time has to agree that that person is then welcome to stay for longer. And usually it's fine, like as long as the person is, you know, contributing and, you know, is here for the right reasons, they are in line with like what we're really trying to do, which is promote sustainability, then that person is welcome to stay for usually. It just depends on case by case basis.
Heck yeah, that's awesome. Tell me a little bit about your like YouTube if you don't mind me asking.
Tree and I have been traveling to intentional communities for the past year and a half since we met. And we've always kind of wanted to document it and just hadn't done it, hadn't really made it happen until I got my van and I saw how big van life kind of stuff is on YouTube. So I was like, all right, this is an opportunity. So we started our YouTube with just like a van tour and that really took off. You know, people really love seeing like van conversions and stuff. So then we're like, all right, let's show these people about intentional communities that we visit. You know, that's really our main mission here. So yeah, we started doing that. We got a lot of attention through TikTok. With this place and a lot of people that were really interested in it, so we gained a lot of traction for our YouTube through that. And yeah, we hope to like, so we visited a community in Costa Rica a couple weeks ago, so we're gonna post a video soon about that, and we hope to like keep going to different communities and showing people places that are actually doing what. So you know, I know so many people that want to buy land and want to do something like this, but don't really have like a practical example of how that happens. So the idea with the YouTube is to keep traveling to different intentional communities and showing people how that's possible, whether that be in the van or it be like us, you know, going to different countries or whatever it might be.
So this is just like one of many that you guys have like been doing things.
But this is maybe one of the most functional examples that we've found. A lot of intentional communities, because they're more structured, kind of have less of a free flow feel. And here I felt like I've been able to step into more of like my own leadership in terms of, you know, if I want to start a project, I'm able to do so. And you know, I can say like, hey guys, I really want to build a labyrinth. If I want to build a labyrinth, then like people are very open here. Like the culture here is to be like very, whoever comes is who's going to create the space. So like personal projects are really encouraged.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Yeah.
Cool, yeah, I think like one thing people think online is that like Tree's like the leader of this place.
And, this is so funny because like we've only been here for 3 months. This place has been around for 12 years, you know.
Yeah.
We are only a small part of what this place is. Tree took on a big role in exposure because that's what this place wanted. You know, when we first came here, it was like a core group of 12 people that had a good thing going, but they were like, we want to show more people about this. Let's figure out how to like spread the message. And that's what Tree took on. And then all of a sudden he's portrayed as like the cult leader, which is crazy. Yeah.
I didn't know about any of the negative, like I didn't hear anything negative. I mean, obviously like people said like cult or whatever, just that word, you know what I mean? It was nothing like death threat-y.
It was weird. It was like, first we like broadcasted to like a specific audience that was really into it. Like people were like, yeah, this is really like intentional community, this is awesome. And then I guess we got to like the next level of viral where like there was a lot of people that didn't understand what it was, and like it was like this like swarm of internet hate that was just like attack, attack, attack. And all of a sudden, like I remember I uploaded this video and I like came back and it had like 500,000 views like overnight, and I was like,
whoa. On your YouTube?
No, on my TikTok.
Okay.
And I looked at the comments and they were like all suddenly like, this is weird. Like, why do they want people to come so bad? Like, I don't understand. Like, this is kind of sketchy. Like, this is sounds really unsafe. Like, this place is unsafe. Like, da 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 da. This place sounds like a really bad place. Blah, blah, blah. And so it was all negative. So I like took the video down. I like freaked out. And I just like didn't know what was happening, so I stopped making. I tried to like answer some questions, and people were like, you know, questions like, "Are you LGBTQ friendly?" And I'd be like, "Yes, we are open to all people." Blah blah blah. And then like my wording in that video wasn't exactly right, so people started attacking me for that, and they were like, you know, she acted like she didn't understand why that question was asked, and like it just like it felt like nothing I said was ever going to make it better.
Yeah.
So I stopped posting. Yeah, and then it just kind of like blew up into this weird thing where they like came up with this whole conspiracy theory that Tree was the cult leader and all this stuff was happening that wasn't true. And it was really hard because then it spiraled into like death threats and like people being like, this place is bad, we're going to come get you, and, you know, and we already put our address out there. So like, it got really scary and we were like, okay, stop. Like, let's stop the social media for a little bit. Like, this is, like, I don't know how this turned around on us, but it did. Like, all of a sudden there's like a hate campaign against us.
Yeah. Wow.
So that was kind of like, yeah, what some of the interviews were focused on was like just how that happened and the emotional impact of that, because like it was scary, you know, like Tree was like having panic attacks, like I was like, you know, everybody kind of felt it, and so many people from the community didn't even know what was going on. They're not even on the internet, so they're like, you know, what's happening, you know? Like,
a friend told me, he was like, there's this TikTok thing, and then I was like, what are you talking about? And he sent me a link, and then that's when I saw the Tree is Alive like page. And then so the first thing I saw of it was like his page, so I went through the TikTok, so it was kind of like I just saw that he was talking about this place, so like I pretty much got it immediately, like I figured what was going on. So coming here and like hearing that it's like a lot crazier than like I thought it was is like,
well, that's what's crazy is I feel like if you watch our TikToks, it's like somebody going around and being like, hey, what are you doing? And everyone's like, we're just hanging out, having fun. And like, for some reason, I feel like so many of the people that made these hate videos like didn't even watch a lot of the TikToks, because they would like, they would address things that like we had already addressed and we'd already said, and they'd be like, why aren't you answering these comments? And we'd be like, we've told a million times that, you know, we're, but like, it was like, I don't know, it was like people were just jumping on the bandwagon of hate before like watching everything.
Yeah.
And yeah, it just kind of spiraled like out of control. But I think people just immediately go to what they've seen in movies and stuff, which is a cult, you know? So like all of a sudden everyone was just like, oh, cult. And it was like, they had no proof. We'd be like, this is why it isn't a cult, because we make all decisions based on consensus and like there is no leader. And they'd be like, it just is. And we're like, all right, like, I don't know what to tell you anymore. That's why we started just, like, blocking the negative comments, because they're just, like, they're really draining, you know? Yeah. Like, it's really a lot to, like, check your phone every day and, like, get tons of hate messages and just be like, okay, like, I guess that's my social media platform now. Like, what, like, I literally just wanted to make videos about how we're growing food here. Yeah. And I don't even have time to answer, because, like, then, like, I go to council and everyone's like, we gotta get the beet seeds in the ground. And I'm like, okay, like, internet is hating on me, but like, I want to grow food.
Yeah.
What's up?
Bro, I'm here. I called you last night.
You got there last night?
Yeah, bro, we spent the night there. We met so many cool people. We,
Tree is Alive.
Bro, yeah, I met Tree is Alive. Yeah.
So is it cool?
Bro, this thing is way crazier than we thought it was. Vice literally just left here.
Fuck yeah, dude. I'm on it. I told you, dude.
Honestly, people don't really even live there. It's actually a bunch of travelers who just come and go. Like, it's just like a travel, like, stop. But if you stay here for a certain amount of time, you gotta just help out. They just wanna teach people how to, like, grow their own shit and not have to support Walmarts and all these other things. We heard about the cat thing. Did you hear about that?
No.
There was a cat that was eating the chicken, and, their farm.
Yeah,
they're a farm, and you can't just have your cats, like, killing the chicken, so they killed the cat. But since they're a farm, they're like, we don't just kill animals and, like, not, like, use all of them. Like,
they ate
the cat. A lot of people didn't think it was crazy, because, like, you know, if, like, something's killing your animals, you kill it and eat it. They said same thing. They had two roosters that were fighting, so, you know, they couldn't just have roosters fighting each other, and it's two dudes, so they kill one of the roosters and eat it. But that's not as big of a story, because people don't necessarily have pet roosters and shit like that. They said, like, people aren't coming out here to check it out. They're just, like, hearing the internet shit and just kind of, like, believing and feeding into all that shit. Like, I think I'm one of the first people who, like, came here and really, like, documented. We're gonna come. I am going to bring you, and you're going to come here, and I think you will love it.
I think you know me. It's mainly now the government for me. I believe that.
the government shouldn't control us.
That's literally what they believe. Mm-hmm. Like, it's cool. It's off-grid, but not that off-grid, which is a really interesting thing. Bro, we're at a Walmart. We only drove 20 minutes away from this place. But it depends on what direction you drive in. There's a group of people that are just traveling. We got here the day before they left. So we're actually about to go to Kentucky to another farm with a bunch of people. I really appreciate you for, like, one, helping us with the gas and fucking telling me about this. All right, bud. Love you.
Love you, too. See you guys.
So we got to Jarvis's house. We're in the bathroom right now. Yeah, he's just a dude with a lot of land. There's like an open door policy here, you know. He came right up to us, and Noah just said, hey, went about his business while we're just chilling in his crib. We came here looking to see this like hippie cult thing that TikTok was talking about, but it turned out we just met a lot of cool people that are traveling. In conclusion, we came here to see what the truth was about this TikTok cult, and we ended up meeting a bunch of awesome people trying to spread awareness of sustainable living. What's fucked up is how often people romanticize hippie culture with statements like, I wish I was alive for Woodstock, it'd be so cool to live in the 70s, fuck the system, blah blah blah. But when people are actually about it, people online want to turn it into something it's not without looking into it. Tree's not some cult leader, he's just some dude traveling who found a spot he wanted to share with the world. This isn't the only sustainable living place, and I can't speak for all of them, but my experience at the garden was fucking dope, and I made a lot of cool new friends. On our way out, we're stopping at the free bus and grabbing a little souvenir. People say others at the garden are crazy, while all they're doing is growing their own food and teaching people how to live off the land. While the rest of us are scrolling looking for conspiracies like Gucci Mane is a clone, the earth is flat, there's this on mute in Tennessee that's actually a cult luring people in on TikTok. The truth is that would be an amazing story, but that's simply not the reality of the garden.
Music up. I'm tryna drink all the bubbly. These girls ain't in love. They just think I'm cute and funny. Low key broke as fuck. They assume that I got money, but I'm not shit. I'm a fucking pothead.
Oh my god. Wow. Cardio, right?
Yeah.